Okay, so today we're going to talk about angle measurement. We need to be able to convert between radians and degrees, and we need to understand what the definition of a radian is. So first, let's draw a unit circle. So the circle. In general, the circle is not a unit circle. It's a circle of radius r, and so to begin with, I'm going to draw that out as a circle of radius r. Let's suppose that r is the radius of the circle. And traditionally, the way we measure angles is in terms of degrees. So we have one revolution is equal to 360 degrees. But this division of the circle into 360 pieces, that's completely arbitrary. The only reason that you use 360 is that 360 is a highly divisible number. So it means that it's easy to divide it into fourths, it's easy to divide it into thirds, into sixths, and twelfths, and fifths, and so forth. So that's why 360 is used, but there's a more intrinsic measure of an angle. And the point is that if you had concentric circles of differing radii, then the angle measurement could be determined by taking the arc length along the larger circle and dividing that arc length by the radius. In that ratio, this arc length to this radius would be the same as this arc length to this radius. So I'm going to call this R and S, and I think I'll call them R2 and S2. I'll call this arc length S1. I'll call this one R1. And so the angle measurement will be the ratio S2 to R2, or S1 to R1. And if you approximated these two things by triangles, you would see that the triangles were similar. And so these ratios are in fact proportional. S2 is to R2 as S1 is to R1. And this measurement, now if we really did use a measuring device with units on it, like a piece of string, when we put that against the yardstick, then we would find out that this quantity is a unitless quantity, but we still give it a name. It's called a radian. And so if this R1 now is a unit circle, or rather, even if it isn't, the circumference of the circle would be 2 pi times R1. And so that would mean that if I wanted to think about this entire angle, it would be 2 pi. So that would be a whole angle. On the other hand, we call a whole angle 360 degrees. Now, by convention,
is
in
that right?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
2 pi is 360 degrees.
The whole circle, right?
Whole circle is 2 pi, it's 360 degrees. By convention, when we're measuring angles, we always run counterclockwise, and the reason is that if we put our palm of our right hand along the positive x-axis and then curled our fingers to the positive y-axis, then the thumb would be pointing out of the blackboard. This is called the right-hand rule, and as you can see, it's very convenient for sinister people because we never have to put our pencil down in order to compute things using the right-hand rule. So we got 2 pi is 360 degrees. Angles are measured in a counterclockwise direction. Positive angles are measured in a counterclockwise direction. And we get pi radians is equal to 180 degrees. Now, when you first deal with angles, somebody is going to ask you to convert, say, 30 degrees to radians, 60 degrees to radians. They'll ask you to convert 2 pi over 5 to degrees. And they'll also ask you some bizarre questions like, what angle is determined by 13 pi over 6, for example. So let's see. Let's do these problems. We want to convert 30 degrees to radians. And we use the idea of units. We think about units. So we have 180 degrees is pi radians. So 1 degree is equal to pi over, no, is 180 over pi. The degrees wind up in the numerator. So if we want to have 30 degrees, no, something's wrong. 1 is 180 over pi. If we want 30 degrees, then we want to cancel the degrees. So we got 30 degrees is equal to 30 divided by 180. The degrees will cancel over pi, so it's going to be pi over 6. 60 degrees, similarly, is going to be equal to 60 pi over 180. 60 degrees, pi over 180 degrees, so that's going to be pi over 3. And let's see what 2 pi over 5 is. So 2 pi over 5 would be a fifth of the circle, and we want to figure out what that is in degrees. So we'll pretend that pi is a unit, cancel the pi's, and then when we do that, we got pi's cancel, we get like that. 5 goes into 180 how many times? That goes in 36 times, 36 times, and so that's going to be 72 degrees. So a 72 degree angle is a fifth of a circle. That makes sense. How about 13 pi over 6? This is a strange angle. 13 pi over 6, let's divide through by pi, multiply through by 180. The pi's cancel. 6 cancels here. We get 30 here. So we have 13 times 30. That's got a 3 in it. That's got a 9 in it. So that's 390 degrees. Now, 390 degrees, let's see. If we went around 360 degrees, we'd be there. So 390 degrees corresponds to an angle. I'll write it like that. Corresponds to an angle of 30 degrees. So if you're actually measuring how far around you went around 13 pi over 6, but if you're trying to determine the angle, then you wind up at a 30 degree angle, or an angle of pi over 6. Similarly, negative angles go this way, and we've talked in other videos about which angles are which.